So hi, hello and welcome, Microbehunter here. These here are calcium oxalate crystals, those bright square structures here. Calcium oxalate crystals in an onion tunic. The tunic is the outermost part of an onion. And today in this video, I would like to show you how you can put an onion under the microscope so that you're also able to see those calcium oxalate crystals. We're going to be using not water as a mounting medium, but rather vegetable oil. Just regular cooking oil is enough, and I will show you how to do that. It's a fairly simple simple preparation of here. I've got a little onion here, and this brown paper-like outside, that is the tunic of the onion, and it's somewhat water-repelling. So if you actually were to use now water, then you're not going to get quite the results that you would like to expect. So I'm going to use vegetable oil, and what I'm going to do first is I'm going to just cut a piece off here. Doesn't have to be very large, and I'm going to it's down here. Let's make it a little bit bigger here. Yeah, it's down here, and what I have to do now is I have to now use some vegetable oil to essentially make a wet mount. And here it is again. It's kind of difficult to catch here. Here we go. Okay, so what I need to do is add a small drop of this vegetable oil now on the microscope slide. Usually I add a drop on the microscope slide first, then I place the object into the oil. So I'm going to do this by simply pushing it over. Yeah, and then I add a small drop on top because I want to make sure that it's really nicely covered. You can see that essentially the oil really likes to cover everything. Usually there are very few bubbles, if any at all. And then at the end, I have to, of course, put a cover glass on top. And essentially, that's it. Maybe we press it a little bit and we're ready to go. That's already it. And I'm going to also show you then later how water would make the whole thing appear a little bit different, because water is not quite as suitable. But let's put it first under the microscope. Yes, this is a regular bright field, and you can already see the individual cells here. Yeah, the cell walls are quite nicely visible, and many of those cells have those calcium oxalate crystals in them. Yeah, and the question, of course, now is why is that? Why do they have those? It is assumed that those calcium oxalate crystals protect the onion from being eaten from insects and maybe also other tiny animals when the onion bulb is in the ground. Apparently, those calcium oxalate crystals do not taste very good, and therefore they serve as a form of protection for the onion. You can also see over here those dark lines that you see. These are most likely the vessels that transport water inside the onion. Yeah, but you can see that the oil, as a matter of fact, causes this onion skin, the onion tunic, to become quite transparent. I would like to show you now also how this would look like when using water as a mounting medium. And if you use water as a mounting medium, then you can already see that there are quite a few bubbles there. And you see that the onion tunic, the onion skin, is also not quite as transparent as when using oil. So in that sense, you can see that sometimes different mounting media are better suitable than others. Yeah, I simply wanted to show this to you very briefly, also to encourage you to experiment around with different mounting media, and always remember that the mounting medium and the specimen should be compatible to each other. Well, I'm going to, I guess, I'm just going to leave it at that. I encourage you also to try out this little activity. But from my side, that's all I would like to share with you today. Happy microbe hunting as always, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.